In this video, we will show you how to map data from one source to two targets. We'll also explain how to replace values from the source file with some other values. Besides, we will show you how to group data by genre and add a comment to a component. Our source component is an Excel file with only one sheet. Let's add our source component to the mapping. Now we need to tweak our component to display each column of the Excel sheet as a mappable node. First of all, we need to select the range that will be used in the mapping. Let's select the table option. This option means that the data from columns A to J and rows 1 to 53 will be loaded. As soon as we select this option, the names of the columns appear automatically. We only need to check the data types of the columns. For example, book IDs and author IDs have a numeric data type. Let's continue selecting the correct data types. The last thing we would like to modify is the row count setting. Let's make it dynamic. This option is particularly useful when you plan to add more rows to your Excel sheet. With a dynamic row count, all the existing rows will be used in the mapping. Now we can see that our source component has each column as a separate node. Our first target file is a JSON schema called books. Let's add our JSON schema to the mapping. Let's first connect the rows node with the object. Then we will connect the title and book nodes. Let's continue connecting all the other nodes. Let's see the output. In our source file, we've got a couple of genres that we would like to modify slightly and then map these modified values to the target. For this purpose, we will need a value map on the connection between the genre nodes. Right-click the connection, then select Insert Value Map from the context menu. First, we want to replace horror with horror and suspense. We also want to replace children's fiction with children's literature. Besides, we need to specify the otherwise condition. The otherwise condition means that all the other genre values will be mapped without any modifications. Now let's check whether we've got correct genre values in the output. We can see that the horror genre has successfully been replaced. And the value of the second modified genre is correct as well. Now we're ready to work with the second target file. Our second target is an XSD schema called Books by Genre. Let's add our second target to the mapping. We will first connect the rows node with the book element. MapForce informs us about multiple targets in the mapping. Thanks to the preview buttons, we can see the output of any of the target components. The next step is to connect the title nodes. Let's continue connecting all the other nodes. Now let's press the preview button of the second target and check the output. In our source file, no grouping criteria have been defined. Our goal is to group the data we map to the second target file by genre. To achieve the goal, we will apply the group by function to the genre element. The first input parameter determines the nodes in which the function will operate. We will connect this parameter with the rows node. For the second input parameter, we need to select the grouping criterion. We want to group our data by genre. The group's output parameter determines the nodes to which the grouping criterion will be applied, in our case the genre element. The last step is to connect the key output parameter with the type attribute. The type attribute will receive the name of a particular genre from the key output parameter. Let's see the output. As you can see, all the books are grouped correctly. MapForce allows you to add sticky note style comments to your mapping. You can add a freestanding comment or a comment attached to a component. Such comments can provide guidance and clarification, which is particularly useful when you have a complex mapping. In this example, we will add a comment to our source component. Right-click an empty area inside the component. Then select Edit Comment from the context menu. Then we will type the following text. Now our comment is attached to the bottom of the source component. You can test all the MapForce features yourself. Simply download a fully featured 30-day free trial from the Altova website.